During this pandemic time, there is a lot of awareness created regarding yoga in people. People are taking their baby steps towards yoga abhyas in whatever way they can. And during the lockdown period and post-lockdown period, people used to request me a lot for making videos. When I asked them what kind of videos would you like to see from my end, the highest demanded video was of Surya Namaskar. So I thought, why not help them out? Why not help out others also to do Surya Namaskar correctly? If you are doing it incorrectly, or if you actually do not know how to do Surya Namaskar, let's solve all the queries related to it in this series. So one single episode definitely would not suffice, or I would say justify, the Surya Namaskar. And so I thought of making a whole series on it, and it would be having some 4 episodes, and this is the first episode. So let's quickly get started. Surya Namaskar seems to be a very basic practice, and so a lot of people, you know, try practicing by their own self. It is not the right way of doing it. After starting my own studio and teaching a lot of people, I realized that unknowingly a lot of people are doing a lot of mistakes in Surya Namaskar, especially in the asana alignment. A lot of people miss a lot of asanas in the cycle, and they don't even realize that they are missing it. And the postures are completely distorted. It's absolutely fine, but do not practice any kind of asanas or Surya Namaskar without learning them properly. So I thought of probably making, if I have some knowledge about the alignments and correct postures, why not share it with you people? Currently doing Surya Namaskar incorrectly would not hurt you much. It would be absolutely fine. But at a later stage, probably you may have severe injuries in your joints, which we actually do not want. And so let's learn the correct way of doing Surya Namaskar. I have a different methodology of teaching, which ultimately ends up to the same results, but in a different process. So I would be doing specific warm-ups related to Surya Namaskar in this video and the coming video. So I've divided this specific warm-ups related to Surya Namaskar into 2 different parts, episode number 1 and episode number 2, right? So before you start doing the asanas, you need to correct your alignments and postures. These warm-ups will help you to warm up your body, plus also correct the postures. Again, if you are practicing Surya Namaskar, don't directly hop onto the mat and start practicing Surya Namaskar without doing full body warm-ups. If you do not know how to do full body warm-ups and Sukshma Vyayam, then quickly have a look at this video flashing above. That is absolutely related to the beginner survival guide for yoga. So without further ado, let's get quickly started with this. Let's start with the step 1 of Surya Namaskar, that is Namaskarasana. Join your feet together, join your palms together, make sure that you're keeping your elbows and your wrists aligned, and go for a chin lock, that is touch your chin to the upper part of the chest. A lot of people do Namaskarasana in these ways. They are completely incorrect ways of going for Namaskarasana. Now we go ahead for the warm up number 1, that is a forward fold and the backward fold. Join your heels together, toes pointing outward, your palms supporting your butts and your lower back. Slowly exhale and bend forward to 90 degree and look in front. Inhale and give a backward arc. Slowly exhale, bend forward. Inhale and go for a backward bend. Now here, while you're going for a backward bend, one very important thing is that you do not overdo it. And if you're having backache, don't go for these kind of backward bends or spine extensions. It is not advisable. We can repeat this for around 10 times. Now we go ahead with Hasta Uttanasana, for which you are supposed to raise your palms up, biceps, triceps touching your ears. Slowly inhale and make an arc, that is a back arc. We will do some pulses over here to become comfortable in this position. We will just simply repeat this step. So now from here, you make sure that your pelvis is tilted in or tucked in, I should say, and your palms are completely up, biceps, triceps touching the floor. A lot of people do it this way. It's completely wrong. That is, you know, you're bending your knees and slowly trying to go back. It's wrong. It is not giving a proper backward bend to the dorsal and the lumbar spine. Now moving ahead with the warm-up number 2, interlock your fingers, slowly exhale and push your interlocked fingers down towards your feet and inhale and up. We will again repeat this for around 10 times. Every time you go down, you're supposed to exhale. Every time you go up, you're supposed to inhale. With this, you'll be able to improve your forward fold slowly and gradually. It's fine if you cannot touch your feet the way I am doing. Take your time. It's not important to bend forward, you know. It's more important to attempt the bends. So keep on pulsing down like this as much as you can. Don't get demotivated if your palms do not touch the feet. Now we will go ahead with the next step, that is Padahastasana. Place your palms exactly besides your feet. And if you feel that you're not able to touch your palms besides your feet, then you can probably bend your knee and slowly touch them down. It's very important if you can see the alignment over here. If my hip is going behind my heel, instead my hip and my heel should be aligned. They should be in a straight line while I'm attempting a forward fold like this. It's very important. Palms in line with your feet is again one very important aspect which you need to consider. Now a lot of people from Hasta Uttanasana to Padhastasana, you know, they go for these kind of actions while, you know, doing this kind of a transition. It's completely wrong. When you are attempting Hasta Uttanasana and Padhastasana transition, you are supposed to raise your palms up, your biceps, triceps touching your ears. You're supposed to straight go down, keeping your back straight and placing your palms down besides your feet. Make sure your back is straight, your spine is extended every time you go down and you place your palms down. Spine extended, back straight, again exhale down. Inhale up, once again exhale and down. All right, now a lot of people do it wrong. What wrong they do? You can see my hip is going behind the heel. It is not completely aligned. Secondly, I'm trying to hunch my back and go down. I'm constantly pushing my upper back down just to go down. So what I'm doing here is, now if I'm unable to go down, I'm still keeping my spine extended, my knees are bent, slowly I'm placing my palm down. It's absolutely fine to stay in this position if you cannot achieve Purna Hasta Padhastasana. Now we go ahead with warm up number 3, that is Parshvottanasana and high lunge. Okay, so we will be doing this movement so that we achieve the next asana, that is Anjaneya Asana of Surya Namaskar. So just go to Parshvottanasana and high lunge. Again, Parshvottanasana and go for high lunge. Keep on switching over in this position. Every time you go down to Parshvottanasana, you make sure that you're touching the heel of the leg behind. And when you go up to low lunge, you're lifting your heel up. Now, from here, we are going ahead with Anjaneya Asana. You're just supposed to, stretch your foot behind slowly as much as you can so that you feel an amazing stretch in your inner thigh, and then slowly place your knee down. You're not supposed to attempt it in this way. As you can see, my knee is going over the toes, and so you can hurt your knees badly in long term if you're practicing it in this way. Neither should your knee go behind the heel. Your knee should be exactly above your heel, keeping a 90 degree angle, and your palms placed besides your feet. Make sure you're pressing your hip down. That is important. Either your toes can be touching the mat or your foot can be flat. As you can see, my hip is up. I'm not stretching it properly over here in this position. So for stretching it properly, I just need to, stretch my leg behind as much as I can and push my hip down and then place my palms down, which will give you an amazing stretch. Now over here, I'm moving ahead with the next warm up, that is Ardha Hanumanasana to Anjaneya Asana. This gives a good, movement to the hip also. So you go to Anjaneya Asana and then half split pose, that is Ardha Hanumanasana. If you're comfortable, you can touch your chin down, but if you're not comfortable, it's fine. If you're finding it difficult to straighten your leg from the knee, then you can also use a prop, a brick or a cushion, you know, while bending forward, or you can also place your palms on the cushion. Now we will repeat the Parshvottanasana and high lunge warm-up with the other side also in the similar manner. So keep on repeating it, Parshvottanasana to high lunge, again Parshvottanasana to high lunge. You are supposed to change the positions every time. This dynamic movement will help you give good stretch in your hips and will also give some hip opening. Now slowly stretch your foot behind, the back foot behind, slowly place your knee down. You can also put your foot flat as I have already demonstrated over here. Now then we will go for Ardha Hanumanasana to Anjaneya Asana dynamic movements. Again, Ardha Hanumanasana to Anjaneya Asana, and we will repeat this as many times as possible. When you go to Ardha Hanumanasana, you will feel an amazing stretch in your hamstrings. As I told you, if it is very difficult, you can place a cushion or place one cushion on your below your right palm, another cushion below your left palm, and slowly go for Ardha Hanumanasana. Now from here, we are going for plank pose, that is Falakasana. Alright, so when we are going for plank pose, a lot of people do this mistake, slowly droop their hip down, their knees down, and you know, they are not placing their shoulders properly, shoulders are locked, or you know, they are improperly placed. So what you need to do is your, yes, again, hyperlordosis is also one of the things which happen, you know. You are not engaging your tummy or your core muscle, and you then that is why the arc comes up, that is lordosis. So that's absolutely wrong. You're not supposed to look down, you're supposed to look straight in front. So this is how the Falakasana will come out. Go to Marjorie and then slowly go for Falakasana. Your hip and your shoulders align. Shoulders are not locked. Your shoulder and your palm are in a single line and you're looking in front, or you're not looking down. Okay. Now slowly we will go to Balakasana and just rest for a while after doing these many warm-ups. Relax over here in this position for a while and again go back to Marjoriasana. Now a lot of people do the mistake in Marjoriasana. Marjoriasana, you are supposed to keep shoulder level distance between your palms and your knees as shown in the video. Once you are done with the distance, you are supposed to join your elbows to the knees like this. Slowly go up on your palms and then take one palm distance. This is perfect distance for Marjoriasana. You are supposed to be on toes so that you can now directly go to the other asana, that is Chatushkona Asana or downward facing dog as we say. Slowly we will shift from Marjorie, lifting up our knees, to Chatushkona. Now I can do this very easily because I have done a lot of practice on this, and that is why my heels are going down very easily. So if your heels are not going down, we will go for these kind of transitions, that is from Marjorie to Chatushkona. Once again, you go to Chatushkona and you exhale down, you go to Marjorie. I'm not keeping my knees down so that I can engage my thigh muscles and I can also work on my core muscles while I am doing these dynamic movements. Now, I will place my knees down, go on my toes, and from there, see, this is how it happens when you go for Chatushkona Asana. You know, your hip are not properly stretched behind, you're not stretching your hip behind, your heels are not touching the floor, and you are constantly trying to look down. Your ears are not aligned, your head is not aligned with the biceps, triceps and your palms. That is absolutely incorrect. These are all the incorrect ways of doing Chatushkona Asana. If your heels are not touching down, it's wrong. After putting a lot of effort and pushing your hip behind, even the heels do not touch down, then you can go for this kind of calf stretching. So slowly just go for calf stretching in this way. See, it's not a matter of 2 to 3 days that you'll be able to achieve this very easily. It'll take its own time. Give it some time. Keep on pushing your heels, your head align with your biceps, triceps, and then slowly relax. So that's it for Surya Namaskar Part 1 Warm Up. I hope you found this video insightful and helpful. If you did, make sure you practice this. You incorporate this routine and you make it a healthy habit in your day-to-day life to improve your health and for the betterment of your health. If you like this video, make sure you share it with your friends and your family members and your acquaintances as well. It's always good to share good things. You can also subscribe our channel so that you can get regular updates about it. Stay tuned till the next video comes up. Ta-ta, bye-bye. Take care, stay safe, stay healthy.